All right, let's go explore America's finest city with one of our favorite co-hosts, if not the favorite, Molly Odell and Linda Moore, top producing realtor. Let's go check out what's happening in Encinitas.
When I get a call from a top producing realtor to head out to Encinitas, you know I'm already on my way. Molly Odell here, and you will not believe why I am out of place today in sandals or high heels out here today in Encinitas. Linda, I always love shooting with you because it gives me the best excuse to come up to Encinitas and Cardiff. So thank you so much for having me out here today.
Thank you, Molly. And you don't need an excuse to come up here. You're always welcome.
Yes.
It is the perfect place on earth to come to, Encinitas. You know that.
I love it up here. So we're here with Annalise today.
Yep.
And where did you bring me to?
Coastal Root Farms.
Oh my gosh.
Isn't that cool?
I just don't think of like the farm and the beach going together.
Yeah.
And you guys did it.
Yeah, and you wouldn't know because we're kind of right in the middle of a neighborhood. So we're an urban farm, a community farm, and we like to invite the community to come and participate in what we're doing. But we're right here in the middle of Encinitas off of Saxony.
That's amazing. Okay, well, it is the middle of fall right now.
Does not feel like it.
No. So I'm always like shocked. I mean, real estate market's always booming in this area. I mean, as you know, people are dying to come here. But I think the number one reason people are wanting to move to the coast is the weather, don't you think?
Yes, the climate. That is definitely the reason why people come here, number one, for sure. 72 degrees year-round on average.
Oh my gosh.
Today is like a summer day. Mm-hmm. Here we are almost at Halloween, and we do have, you know, periods of time where we have these Santa Ana conditions where it's dry and hotter, but overall, the climate is perfect year-round. Very little rain and just a perfect climate.
That's amazing. Well, I've lived in San Diego my whole entire life, so I've never experienced like the snow or like awful downpour, but I'm seeing people like wanting to move here for their first home, but also their second homes too.
Yes, because if they live in a climate that is too hot in Arizona and they want to come here, you know, when it's opposite, or if they live in a cold place like Canada and they want to come here for the winter, it's perfect as a second home as well.
I think that's smart. I think that's what I'm gonna do. Stay in San Diego and buy a second home up here so I have an excuse to come up here. And now that I found this wonderful farm, Annalise, so tell me a little bit about, so I was driving through, and this is beautiful neighborhoods up here. Linda, you've introduced me to the best neighborhoods, but I was driving through these neighborhoods and I turn and there is literally a full-blown farm.
Yep.
So tell me about it.
So we have 20 acres here. We're on the Leech Tide Commons property, and the Leech Tide Commons property is owned by the Leech Tide Foundation. Coastal Roots Farm was actually incubated by the Leech Tide Foundation back in 2014. So we started the farm back then. It's grown a lot in just 3 years. We officially became our own 501c3 nonprofit in 2016.
That's huge.
Yeah, it's really exciting. So now, as you can see, behind us are the veggie production fields. So we're producing hundreds of thousands of pounds of food all the time. I think we've donated around 800,000 pounds of food to date since our inception. We also host community events and lots of Jewish agricultural festivals, volunteer events, lots of chances for people to come and connect to the community and also where their food comes from.
Okay, so I want to let's start with the donation factor because I think that's huge. You and I were talking earlier, and Linda, you were telling me some of the great things they do here. Tell me about how you guys are donating food.
Sure. So since we've been around as a farm, we've donated over half of what we've grown. So that's since 2014. Over half of our harvest has gone to community members who lack access to fresh food. So how we do that, one is through our farm stands. We have Pay What You Can farm stands where people can come and take whatever they need, take local, fresh, seasonal, organic vegetables, and then they can just pay whatever they're able to. So some people give more than the suggested donation prices, some people give less, it's whatever they're able to. So our on-site farm stand, which we're standing in now, is Thursday afternoons, 2 to 6 p.m. and Sundays 10 to 3 p.m. We also do a couple off-site markets at a health clinic and then at Camp Pendleton. So we have a few going on in the community, but our on-site one is always here Thursdays and Sundays.
San Diego really is a big military community, and you can really speak on that. We have a lot of people moving, you mm-hmm. know, that get, yeah. you know, stationed here. And you guys directly donate food to Camp Pendleton, so you guys go up there.
Right, so we're there twice a month. We have a farm stand that's just a pop-up farm stand that goes at the military base. And we just make our food available for free. So anyone can come and access food and just grab whatever they need. And we have recipe sheets for them so they can learn how to use the food and, you know, kind of sheets identifying what the vegetables are. So if they're not familiar with it, they can come and learn what their vegetable is and then also take new food home. So we hope that we're introducing them to new nutritious food that they incorporate into their diet. We hope that we're making it more accessible for them in a way that's culturally appropriate and in a way that they'll actually incorporate into their health regimens for the long haul.
That's amazing.
Tell us about the composting.
Yeah, so we do a lot of composting here at the farm. We have a huge compost system going on. You can't see it here. It's kind of up past the food forest. But we like to invite the community in to help with this. So one thing that community members can do is if they have extra food and food scraps, so food waste like eggshells or vegetable rinds, they can just bring it to the farm and we'll give it to our chickens who will first eat it and then they'll kind of, you know, dig through it in search of bugs. They'll scratch through it and the dirt will kind of work with the food scraps to aerate, and then we'll use all of that deep litter, is what we call it, and we'll incorporate that into our compost system. So it goes from food waste to something really useful and nourishing for the soil, which is compost.
Okay, so I think that's amazing because every single morning when like I'm peeling my cucumber or my apple for my smoothie, so I can drop that all off here?
Absolutely, yeah. Anything that you have that's, you know, a vegetable waste or fruit, eggshells, anything like that, just bring it to the farm and we'll give it to our chickens.
I think that's really cool. And that's,
yeah.
I know you guys have somebody like a compost specialist on site too, or
yes,
something you can speak with.
Yeah.
You guys have more questions? Don't ask it.
Ellie is awesome. I don't know all about the compost, but Ellie is awesome and she's our compost coordinator and she'll work with the community members to make sure that they know where to put their food scraps.
I think it's great. Well, Linda, thank you so much for always inviting me to the coolest places.
Thank you.
And thank you for introducing me to the farm.
Thank you. Thanks for coming here.
Thank you.
I would never expect this beautiful garden farm to be right here on the coast of Encinitas. So thank you so much, Annalise, for introducing me to this wonderful location. And as always, Linda Moore, thank you for having me out to your hometown.